Ready? You can go too.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. The big reveal.
I'm about to go crazy in the streets now.
All right, so we got the trunk. And a lot of people wrap trunks, they like, you know, wrap it in the seam. So I'm gonna show you exactly how to wrap a trunk and why you have to do it this way. So, none of this is, the top has not been, it's just glassed out. It has not been squeezed out at all, but I am gonna run it right here down the middle just to lock it in. So, all right. So you always want to use a lot more. Never ever cut it here, here. Use a lot. So I'm gonna show you how you want to warm it up. Real nice and hot. You want to start, always start from the middle. Just read the wrinkles. You don't want to pull it. You'll overstretch the material. Kind of just want to let it warm up. And you just sit it down. Boom. So, we got the middle. You can either work this way or that way, but I'm going to come this way. If you guys can see, so we're going to come this way. Be hot enough, and then give it a slight pull, and kind of just let it fall in place. We want to warm this section up since I didn't get to it. And then you want to lock it into place. So, as you can see, this side is done. The car actually ends right here. So we're gonna squeeze all of this in. We got little guys here, but took care of those. So now, like I said, start from the middle, do that side, and now we're gonna lay this side. Don't pull the material, just hold it. Just let it do its own thing. Alright, now we want to pull. Well, not pull, but kind of just let it fall into place. Give it a slight tug, not too hard. Over here. Now we're good to go. Now all I want to do is get these little guys out right here. Where's my glove? Application glove. Boom. We have, you know, you have your little, these little tiny little fingers here. I'm not sure if y'all can see those or not, but basically kind of just rub those in. And boom, and actually ends here. So that
is how you lay a trunk.
Boom, boom. And all you gotta do is squeeze your way.
So, start from the middle. Heat it up nice and warm. Always use extra material. That way you got enough. And then when it comes to here, when you get to that bottom, you won't have any like pullback or wrinkles trying to come up. So that's kind of how you wrap trunk. Woo! All right, we back. So, after you're done pulling and doing all of this, so everything is basically laid. Everything is in there. This is in there really, really well. Everything is laid. So now all you gotta do is make the cuts. But before, the most important part is you do not want to make any cuts yet. Take the heat gun and see what these wrinkles. And heat gun that. You see how it's not moving at all? That means there's no overstretch. So now I gotta do make the cuts and lay it in there. Now, since it's all heated up and you didn't see him finger and curl up like this, then you're good. You didn't overstretch the material, and now you can lay it in there and it'll be perfectly fine. So always post heat everything. No matter what you do, anytime you're done laying the material, always post heat. If you don't post heat, you will get fingers in the material. So let's see if I can get a bubble or something to come up. All right, there we go. Can you see that? Right there. You see that? I'm really hoping you guys can see that. I don't think you can see it. Anyways, you always want to post heat because a little bubble came up right there. And post heating also helps activate the material. Well, the adhesive to get it to really stick and stay there for longevity. So those are my tips. Watch the customer's reaction.
Man, turn around. Thank you.
Quick, 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 quick,